I kind of have two questions for you.
Okay.
Okay, the first question is, have you guys heard of the Type and Type Abridged series?
Dope!
It's hilarious, isn't it?
So good. Have you seen it?
No, I haven't.
Oh my god, it's so funny. It's the funniest thing ever.
And then my second question is, it's it's kind of referring to how dark this anime is. Normally, I watch things that are a lot more happy-go-lucky.
Sure.
But the question is that, don't you think it's kind of redundant how Eren loses his leg in the first place?
Yeah,
yeah,
I mean, is it redundant? Yeah. Because he loses his leg a number of times?
Yeah. Maybe.
Because it grows back, right?
Well, it doesn't...
It grows back after he goes into Titan.
Yeah.
Right.
But I'm just saying, like, don't you find it kind of messed up how it's like, oh yeah, he's going to go off and kill Titans, and now he's the one that's getting killed.
Yeah. That was really jacked. I didn't know anything about it going in. Like, I only watched the first episode before my audition, and then once I got the part, I didn't watch anything or read anything per Mike McFarlane, the director's request. Mm-hmm. And so when I was recording and she finds out that Eren's dead, I'm like, what? He's the main character. What does that mean about my job? Like, that's messed up, man.
Game of Thrones all over again.
Yeah, I think just because it's so dark and because the minute you fall in love with a character, you're like, oh, and they're dead. Okay. You know, that Marco guy seems really nice. Thank you. Almost have Armin, but obviously that doesn't happen because Eren. And then you have, I don't remember Alexis' character, I think her name's Mina, black haired chick with pigtails, not Nikita. A lot of people confuse each other.
Well, I don't have pigtails.
No, you don't. My hair is very different. And then there's another guy too. But yeah, that whole thing is like, yeah, I'm going to go fight some Titans. I'm feeling really motivational, and I'm like, inspired and all that, and then he loses his leg.
I think it's an interesting sort of plot structure or narrative construct or whatever to have Eren be so... I mean, you want Eren from the beginning because of what he's gone through to be like this hero, to be a badass, to be able to go and just defeat everybody.
Yeah.
And the fact that his passion and his just, you know, intensity drives him to go in and probably before he should, the fact that you then kind of, after that, you sort of worry about Eren a little bit. Like, you go, okay, dude, don't die.
Yeah.
You
get it. You want to kill the Titans.
But I think that's great, because as an audience, then you want him to be the hero, and you're also like, dude, don't die. So
that's
perfect. Yeah.
That's
also
the episode where Josh had to scream like bloody murder twice. Where the Titan Santa Claus almost swallows him, and you hear him scream as he's going down and coming down that Eren saves him. And then when the Titan, you know, actually eats Eren, oh my gosh, every time I hear that I feel it. I feel it. And Josh did an amazing job with that. Just really played Armin, yes. It's weird because everyone knows in acting land, you're like, oh yeah, like Josh Hewitt. Like I don't even, when people say Lauren and Danny, now like they're both interchangeable.
Yeah.
Like Bertel and David,
totally.
same person.
Thank you.
So yeah, I usually do identify, but I totally forgot.
No problem.
Thanks for your question.
Yeah,
thank you.
Question.
Who here has seen Attack on Titan Junior High?
Nice.
It's awesome.
It's fun.
It's so much fun. I loved a lot of scenes in Junior High. My favorite episode so far that has been released is the love letter episode with John. I think it's hilarious, and I love the dodgeball episode. And Annie are always fighting one way or another.
Like, take
And it's really funny because I could just imagine you in front of the mic just being super badass. It's really funny to me. But yeah, I love that episode. It's so funny. I love hearing everybody just have a great time with this show. Because the main series is so heavy and it's so tragic, and then we get to have a little fun with the characters. You know, not that the show isn't fun, but like, you know, funny, hilarious situations as opposed to death.
Yeah.
So I think my favorite part about Douglas Hyatt in junior high is Honey Springer.
Yeah.
Like, if you like, if you totally isolate like his dialogue and his lines, they are amazing. When I go to record, I have to have his stuff muted because he's just so funny. He has a whole, like in the first episode when he's like skipping down the street, he's singing a song about pigeons that he made up on the spot. Which is amazing.
I love his voice.
So good.
I know.
And like, I think it's episode 2 when, or maybe it is episode 1 still, but when the Titans are eating, they're stealing all of his bento boxes. And so Mika's just like getting ready to like pump herself up to fight them or whatever. And she's like, this is fair, and like figuring it out for herself. But in the meantime, you have Connie in the background going, my mom made that fried chicken.
It's funny you say that because I was recording this past Monday on the episode that's about to come out, and I couldn't stop saying, I love that guy. Yeah, he's so funny. Just everything about him, what he says, but also the voice, just where his voice is in both series. I love that, actually. Mine is less of a specific scene, but more of just getting the opportunity to be so much more cartoony. Like, most of the roles that I've played in anime, there are some where I've been able to kind of let loose and be more cartoony, but I just don't typically get cast that way. And getting with Bertolt, you know, when he gets hit in the face with a volleyball, and getting to, like, you know, have crazy over-the-top reactions where you can really just do anything, you know? I love that. It's, and my favorite thing about it so far is the episode that's about to come out.
Mine too.
Which I can't say anything about.
That's gonna probably be my favorite episode. It's awesome and it's fantastic. And both David and I are incredibly entertained by it.
When is it out? When is it air?
I think Wednesday.
Yeah.
I think Wednesday night.
Yeah.
That's what I have been told. So I'm very excited. It's gonna be awesome. But yes, the pigeon song is hilarious. It's okay. Q-Q, that's what pigeons say. It's so funny. It's ridiculous.
Did you guys have to do all the lunchtime Walla stuff? Where, like,
yes.
That's my favorite thing to do. Like, hey, man, is that milk? I really want that. Like, we just make up stuff, like, you know, for lunchtime chatter. It's awesome.
I don't say anything.
You know, just make noises.
Well, I'm Mika's.
Oh, okay.
Mike's like, okay, so just say whatever Mika would say to Eren. Like in the lunchroom, it's like a whole minute of everybody else, like, oh, da da da. Like, he is character, is like, I'm gonna feed you like a, I can't say it, I'm gonna feed you like a baby bird. And it's really funny, and everybody else has funny things to say. And I'm like, like, there's nothing to say. But there's also in the dodgeball episode, Connie doesn't get the idea of how to play dodgeball. He gets hit and then he catches it and then he tosses it back to the opposite team. And John's like, what are you doing?
So funny.
Thank you for bringing it. Thank you
for
the question.
Hi.
You look fantastic.
Thank you. So I was wondering, how do you guys feel about your guys' character on SacAnime and their development throughout season 1?
Well, there's a lot of mystery about my character, you know, and I love that. I mean, there's even in the scene where you see him more and you kind of learn a little bit about his history and all that, it's like talking to somebody who you realize, you kind of feel like they're telling you some of the truth, but it's not everything. And you don't know why. It could just be that he's just really shy and doesn't know how to really communicate that way. I love that attribute because as a voice actor, you know, you get to to put little things into your voice and make choices about what isn't being said. But so yeah, that journey of where is he going to go, and what is he going to be, and what is his real, why is he really there, you know? But bringing up back to Titan Junior High, what's cool about that too, besides it's fun and cartoony and all, we get that fun, is you get to kind of make up, oh wow, this is what he was like in junior high, and how did he, you know, that's fun too. So yeah, that's my knee-jerk reaction to that question.
Mika's growth throughout the show, I think I kind of touched on earlier, but I think that in general, as an actor, I think it's really fun because Mikasa and Eren and maybe Armin too we all had different ages, right? We were super young and kind of young in our show age. So being able to grow with her and start young and get older, which the director was maybe telling me to do, was really interesting, and it was really cool to be able to go on a journey with the character. And I think it made me love her like that much more because you just kind of grow attached to these voices in your head, and you're like, oh yeah, I have voices in my head. I've got a way to say it. I think it's been a really amazing journey, and I'm excited for season two to see what happens.
When I first saw Titan, when I got the role of Annie, I had never seen it. I didn't know anything about it. I didn't even know there was an anime until I got the audition for it. But when I did finally have a chance to watch it, I have recorded at least one or two episodes, and I said, should I watch this show? Mike McFarlane, the voice director, also the voice of Sean Kirstein. I said, should I watch this show? And he said, yeah, you should. Pretty good, but don't watch past episode 13 because that's when spoilers start to come in. And I said, sure, shouldn't be too hard. Yeah, right. So I went home and I started watching it, and Annie comes in, and I honestly didn't think there was going to be anything with her character because she was just, you know, the side monotone character who doesn't really show a lot of emotion, and I honestly thought there wasn't going to be anything with her, and especially when we don't see her, like her, for quite a few episodes, and so I'm like, well, either way, I'm cool, I'm like, I'm happy to be a part of the show, and then when that whole thing happened, I was like, what? What? So that was pretty amazing for me. As far as her growth, I don't feel that I've seen, not that I haven't seen growth from her, but like you don't know her well enough yet. So I can't say for sure.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.